Imagine you're on a sightseeing cruise, enjoying a peaceful vacation at sea. Everyone's quiet, eating in the restaurants. Children playing on the slides and adults eating something in the restaurant. When suddenly, and without any warning, a huge wave, 98 feet high, as big as a 12-story building, appears out of nowhere and hits the cruise ship sideways. The blow is heard as a bang, an immense mass of hundreds of tons hitting the metal. This colossal wave fails to cause the cruise ship to sink, but it causes extensive damage to the ship's structure, breaking glass, knocking down doors, and flooding much of the interior areas of the cruise ship. After this, a second wave of the same size slowly approaches like a huge mountain of water. If it manages to hit the cruise ship, it will be the end. Well, although this sounds like a science fiction movie, it is an event that could happen any day. It is not a tsunami, but something much more dangerous and unpredictable. A monster wave, also known as a rogue wave. Do you want to know what this exciting phenomenon is all about and why they are so dangerous? Keep watching to find out.
Audio Jungle.
Monster waves are huge, unpredictable waves that appear suddenly and without warning. These are extremely dangerous to ships and isolated water structures such as oil rigs, lighthouses, and weather stations. Despite their similarities, rogue waves are not the product of earthquakes like tsunamis. On the contrary, its origin is even more unknown. And even today, its origin remains a subject of research for science. It should be clarified that, although they have many similarities, rogue waves are not tsunamis. The latter are vast masses of water formed as a result of disturbances on the seafloor, such as earthquakes and volcanic eruptions. In addition, tsunamis tend to be completely harmless in the open sea, as the bodies of water move gradually. Tsunamis are most dangerous on coasts, as this is where they hit bodies of water and can cause great destruction. In contrast, monster waves, as the name implies, are independent and huge waves that occur unexpectedly in a small area and only affect boats or open and isolated structures. Unlike tsunamis, which can be predicted as they usually occur after an earthquake or volcanic eruption, rebel waves are completely unpredictable, which is why they are so dangerous. What is considered a rebel wave or monster wave? Rogue waves are significantly bigger than the waves in the surroundings. For example, imagine a ship sailing in an area where the waves are, on average, not exceeding 16 feet high, and suddenly, a 49-foot wave appears and crashes head-on into the boat. That wave can be considered a rogue wave, since it is three times larger than the waves in the surrounding area. Monster waves are distinct from regular ocean waves due to their considerable height and unpredictable nature. Often, these waves appear suddenly amid relatively calm ocean conditions, which can surprise boaters and pose a severe danger to vessels. Most boats are not prepared to face such large waves. Offshore and during a storm, waves can reach heights of up to 26 to 29 feet. It's rare to find waves more than 29 feet high, but rogue waves can reach up to 99 feet high, equivalent to a 12-story building. Sailors' stories. Although it may seem new, monster waves have been present in nautical literature in different stories. In 1826, French scientist and naval officer Captain Jules Dumont d'Urville reported waves up to 108 feet in the Indian Ocean, with three colleagues as witnesses. Still, his fellow scientist François Arago publicly ridiculed him as a wave of such a size, something completely impossible. At the time, it was widely believed that no wave could exceed 30 feet in height, so no one believed the claims of scientist Jules Dumont. However, author Susan Casey defended the scientist's opinion by writing that much of that disbelief about the maximum size of waves was due to the fact that very few people had seen a wave of that size and had survived to tell the tale. For centuries, maritime legends of the high seas spoke of the existence of much larger waves, real monsters up to 99 feet high that could appear without warning in the middle of the ocean, against the current and the dominant direction of the waves, often in perfect atmospheric conditions. Sailor stories said that such waves were like a huge wall, almost vertical, like a huge mountain of water that appeared suddenly and without any warning. Any ship unlucky enough to encounter a wave of such magnitude had no chance of surviving, because a wave of that size would exert a tremendous pressure of more than 100 tons per square meter, sinking the boat in a matter of seconds. One of the most transcendental accounts on the subject corresponds to an essay written shortly before Europeans arrived in America. The King of Portugal encouraged this previous trip. The monarch decided to explore the territories near Africa, so he sent a crew of three ships with orders to discover as much as possible. But they didn't expect that during a stopover on the Atlantic Ocean islands, they would face a storm accompanied by what appeared to be a monster wave. The Baron of Rosmethal, who was part of Alonso V's court, wrote, "Suddenly there appeared waves as great as mountains that appeared to reach the clouds, whereupon everyone felt a terror as great as if the day of judgment had come, for they knew that there was no way of escape." For years, the scientific community denied such accounts by sailors, claiming that mathematical models indicated that waves more significant than 15 meters high were events so rare as to occur once every 10,000 years. This was because, according to the mathematical calculations used to model waves based on a Gaussian shape, in a stormy sea with waves 39 feet high, the model suggests that a wave greater than 49 feet would rarely occur, and a wave of 98 feet could occur, but only once every 10,000 years. For years, scientists, meteorologists, and oceanographers made their calculations and came to the consensus that this was a reasonably close approximation to reality. However, sailors did not think so. Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. The monster waves in history. Throughout history, different events have been linked to gigantic waves that cause great destruction. Some of them are Eagle Island Lighthouse, 1861. Water shattered the glass of the structure's east tower and flooded it, implying a wave that exceeded the height of the 130-foot cliff and destroyed the 85-foot tower. USS Memphis, August 29, 1916. An armored cruiser formerly known as USS Tennessee was wrecked while stationed in the port of Santo Domingo, resulting in 43 men killed. Witnesses who survived say the boat was sunk by three waves, the largest estimated at 70 feet high. The SS Edmund Fitzgerald, 1975, was an American freighter that sank in Lake Superior during a storm with the loss of the entire crew of 29 men. Initially, the Coast Guard attributed the wreck to water ingress into the hatches, which gradually filled the hold and caused the sinking. Still another ship, the SS Arthur M. Anderson, which was closely following the SS Edmund Fitzgerald, was hit at the same time by two rebel waves and possibly by a third. And this was reason enough to think that what sank the Edmund Fitzgerald was the blow of one or several monster waves. MS Munchen, lost at sea, leaving only scattered debris and signs of sudden damage from a wave more than 66 feet high. Although more than one wave was probably involved, this is still the most likely sinking due to a gigantic wave. Ocean Ranger, February 15, 1982, was a self-propelled, semi-submersible mobile marine drilling unit. On the night of February 15, 1982, Ocean Ranger reported experiencing stormy seas with waves 55 feet high and the occasional wave of up to 65 feet. This caused the entire structure to sink into the Atlantic Ocean at 3:07 a.m. Its entire workforce of 84 was killed. For years, hundreds of accounts from different witnesses seemed to corroborate the obvious. Waves of more than 20 meters existed, and many people had managed to survive them. However, the scientific community still could not find evidence of them beyond the accounts and stories of sailors. But this quickly changed in the new age of technology. The first scientific evidence for the existence of giant waves came with recording a rogue wave on the Gorm Shelf in the central North Sea in 1984. In relatively calm weather, a prominent wave with a height of 36 feet was detected at this location. However, what caught the scientific community's attention was the digital measurement of a rogue wave on the Draupner Shelf in the North Sea on January 1, 1995. This event was called the Draupner Wave. It was highly controversial in the scientific community, as it was the first time in history that very precise measured data was obtained from what appeared to be an 84-foot wave height. As a result of this measurement, other scientists began placing sensors on buoys around the world, And little by little, they began to have a record of waves exceeding 65 feet in height in all the world's oceans. Thanks to this, it is known today that rebel waves exist and are common phenomena not only in the seas and oceans of the entire planet, but can also occur in the Great Lakes, such as those in the northern United States. How to predict them? Nowadays, rogue waves are accepted as a common phenomenon and not as a myth or legends of sailors. Even Professor Ochmedier of the Australian National University has claimed that there are 10 rogue waves in the oceans around the world at any given time. Some researchers have speculated that about 3 out of every 10,000 waves in the oceans reach a rogue state. However, in certain places, such as coastal inlets and river mouths, these monster waves can account for 3 out of every 1,000 waves, because wave energy can be concentrated in smaller spaces. However, even though we now know more about these monster waves, we cannot predict them. Scientific research that attempts to explain the origin of these waves raises different possibilities. From the result of interference from different wave systems that acquire energy from the surrounding waves, to the effect of the seafloor on the waves. But there's still no consensus on how or why such huge waves form. Will one of our subscribers solve this mystery? Rogue ocean holes are another mystery produced by the same effect as monster waves. As you can imagine, they are the opposite of rogue waves. They are areas where the depth of the ocean can reach a depth significantly greater than that of the surrounding area, like a kind of local abyss that occurs momentarily in a region of the ocean. Rogue ocean holes have been replicated in experiments using water wave tanks, but they have not been confirmed in the real world, although boaters have reported seeing them. Could it be that rogue ocean holes also exist? Would you like us to make a video on this topic? Let us know what you think in the comments.